Thanks for joining the Astro Room, your very own portal to the cosmos. I am here doing space news tonight. This is extremely important. I have my Seestar, as you can see here on the right side, live imaging the almost full moon. Full moon is just a couple days away. And today, Thursday, the 22nd of February, the first U.S. craft lands on the moon in over 50 years. The first U.S., everyone. This is amazing. I'm so excited to share this while I'm imaging the Seestar. I'm so excited. So I'm imaging right now the moon live, as you can see. Okay. And let's check this out. I've been following this story, and I think it just would be so awesome to just talk about this as I'm imaging. I'm sure a lot of you guys have already seen this. Let me move my Seestar over a little bit. Let's watch this little video of the reaction when it landed. I'm going to move this down a bit. This is just incredible.
It's on the surface of the moon, and we are transmitting. So, congratulations on your team. Today or later, but we are on the surface, and we are transmitting. And welcome to the moon.
So that's right, everyone, from Houston. This company, let's dig into this company. Let's see what data they already are giving us from the moon. This happened today, like I mentioned. And let's see what data they're talking about here. I'm going to click on this here. So it's the first commercial, like private company that lands on the moon. We know India recently landed on the moon, but they're actually a space agency, a governmental agency. So as you all know, so recently there was a private company that tried to do this, okay? Also a U.S. company. This was last month in January. Moon landing attempted by private company abandoned after critical fuel leak. This is coming straight from PBS NewsHour. I always try to, of course, give good sources for these news, guys. I'm not just pulling out whatever, okay, here. So this recently tried to do it. They abandoned. I was watching this too, down to the last minute. They tried. They didn't make it. So it's not easy. It's not easy. So this company, Intuitive Machines, that made it is that's incredible. That's incredible. You know. They are a Texas-based private company. They're the first private company to be able to land on the moon. They called their lander Odysseus, or Odie for short. They said it was a nail-biter. Their CEO said this. So it says the company was able to confirm that Mission Control received signals from the lunar surface shortly after landing. But it wasn't until 2 hours later that Intuitive Machines, which is the company, right, shared that the spacecraft was upright and started to send data. I was watching it live, and it was a nail biter. It was, because we weren't sure, like, when they said it landed, they couldn't transmit, like they lost signal. It was crazy. So they're putting stuff on Twitter. Let's see what's going on. Oh, this is really cool. This is the lander. Oh my god. Oh my goodness. Let's look at them on X, or Twitter, right? It's now known as Twitter. And let's see what they're saying. I'm going to refresh the page. From my understanding is that they're trying to send live data, like trying to send data and show it to the world, like the moon, right? Like images, video. And, you know, you'd think in this age of technology, like this could be done quickly. Right? Like, come on, they made it to the moon. And sometimes I wonder, it's not the fact that maybe they don't have the data already. I wonder if it's just they're looking at it first before they reveal it to the world, right? That's my guess. I mean, it's the first private company to do this. So let's look at this. If you look at their Twitter page here, or, you know, Twitter is now known as X, okay? We look at X, their page, Intuitive Machines, the name of the company. Let me try to zoom in here for you guys. There we go. Intuitive Machines. We open access to the moon for the progress of humanity, science and technology. Company based out of Houston, Texas. Here we have it. Maybe we'll click on their website. Check out what's up with them. So Intuitive Machines. Okay, here we go, guys. So 4 hours ago, They said, after troubleshooting communications, flight controllers have confirmed Odysseus is upright and starting to send data. Right now, we are working to downlink the first images from the lunar surface. Oh, come on. There must be tons of comments on this. Like, where is it? Where's the data? We've got 1,000 comments here. Should we read them? Yeah, so we've got the director of NASA, Bill Nelson here, talking about it from the launch pad. Oh my gosh, yeah. Like, oh gosh, this is awesome. Oh my god, let's look at this. 5 hours ago, your order was delivered to the moon. Okay, so the uncrewed lunar lander, right, Odysseus, landed at 6:23 p.m. Eastern U.S. time, right, bringing NASA science to the moon's surface. These instruments will prepare us for future human exploration of the moon. Here they are. This is when they're celebrating. There they are. Wow. Yeah, I'm telling you guys, this was a nail biter. Let's click on this company's website. I wonder, I haven't looked at this. Let's, mission updates. Oh my goodness. You know, the fact that a private company is trying to do this, can you imagine how many more companies? There's tons of them. There's tons of them that are trying. Look at that. They have 200 or more employees. Interesting. Founded in 2013. Wow. How many years have they been trying? I'm sure they, it took them years to get to this point. This is really cool though. This is really cool. Yeah. They're putting updates. It looks like their Twitter. I'm going to keep following their Twitter and see, you know, we just want to know like, when are these images coming? Maybe not till tomorrow, I'm guessing, right? Let's look at the moon phase. We have the Seestar live imaging, the almost full moon. The full moon is in a couple of days. And check it out. Check out all the news on this right now. It's just trending. It's going like crazy. I'm going to keep zooming in here. Look at this, everyone. Top stories, right? CNN, that's the one we just saw. Yahoo talking about it, a giant leap for private space endeavors. This is amazing. Built spacecraft lands on the moon for the first time since 1972. New York Times talking about it. Odysseus lunar lander makes moon landing, but signal was weak. I believe this because, like I was telling you guys, I was watching it live when they were landing and they lost the signal. Like, right when it landed, they were flipping out. That must have been a tense moment for them because they were live. NASA was streaming it live. Yeah, historic for a U.S. company. Let's click on this. Intuitive Machines Nova Sea cargo lander named Odysseus. I want to see a little bit more about this lander. Okay, here's a picture of it. Look at the... Oh, this is in lunar orbit on February 21st. This is it when it's getting close to the moon. Wow. We are on the surface and we are transmitting. Welcome to the moon, the CEO said. There was a delay as expected between the landing and when the engineers were able to assess its success. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. I want to click on that. Let's go back when it said they had a weak signal. This is AP News. This is reliable news here. Private lander. Okay. Makes debut. Despite the spotty communication, so... Manage just a weak signal. Can you guys read this? I'm going to zoom in a little bit more. Look at this. A weak signal until flight controllers scrambled to gain better contact. Yeah, it was like several minutes. While if you were watching this live, it was several minutes. So despite spotty communication, the company that built and managed the craft confirmed that it landed upright, but it did not provide additional details, including where the lander had reached its intended destination near the moon's south pole. The company ended its live webcast soon after identifying a lone weak signal from the lander. Wow. Okay, but they can confirm without a doubt that it is on the surface of the moon. Okay, so they were in the company's Houston Control Center. This is so interesting. I'm gonna refresh this page. When are they going to release these images, guys? I'm going to refresh their Twitter. Oh, come on. Probably not till tomorrow. Okay, still. All right, everyone. So it looks like they do not have the data yet. Man, I was hoping that we could see this. This is... All right, everyone. Well, thank you so much for tuning in. I will plan to do more of these space news because... who doesn't love space? I love space. Everyone loves space. That's why we're here, the Astro Room, your very own portal to the cosmos. And remember, if you find this content valuable, if you want me to continue bringing you news, space news, okay, all of this stuff, if you want me to continue this, please hit the like, please subscribe. That tells me that you want to watch this, right? A lot of my viewers, from what I'm understanding, is over 80% of my viewers are not subscribed. So a lot of you haven't subscribed yet. First of all, thank you for watching. Come in here with me, right? Let's keep doing this together. Let's build this community of all of you who love the cosmos, who love space, and let's keep watching this together. This is going to be exciting. I'm going to give you more space news as we go on, but I'll only know if you subscribe. So please subscribe, please support, and let's keep it up here with the Astro Room. Keep looking up, your portal to the cosmos. Thanks again for watching, everyone.